Today we are going to talk about functions part 2. So before this part we have already introduced the functions. Now we are going to talk about the functions that can return a value. How can we pass the parameters to the functions and how can we use local variables? And we are going to provide some various hints to be successful using functions. Now, of course, when you write some functions, it's a good idea. Always put a function header comments. So this is called function header comments. In the function header comments, you know, these are the command lines, huh? But a little bit fancy way. Okay. And the first comment, the name of the function. The next comment, what are the inputs, parameters, and for what reason, what are the type? And what's going to be the output? So what is the behavior of the function? So that's a good idea to put all these together as a function header comment. Why? Because you are not going to leave alone. You are going to write the codes with others. So you have to do the collaboration with your other friends. Okay. So please pay attention to this. Other friends, other teammates will not understand what this function works for and what are the parameters, what is the reason, blah, blah. So try to put this. Okay. Then we have the what. What is that part? Anybody remembers? What is that? It is function header, right? It is function header. Huh? No, it's not function header. It's a function prototype. Is that right? It's a function prototype. No, it's not function prototype. What is that altogether? Function definition. This is function definition. Why? Why? Because we have the function header, plus we have the function body. So when we have all together, it is going to be function definition. All right. All right. So yeah. So let's see that what does this function do. Now, what is the name of the function? Average 2. How many parameters it takes? 2. What is the first parameter name? Num1. What's the second parameter name? Num2. What is the first parameter data type? Integer. What is the second parameter data type? Integer. Does this function returns you some value? Yes. What is the data type of that value? Float. Now, what is the behavior of the function? So what is the function body? What does this function do? Let's see. So what is that? So it is a local variable. So local variable means that it can belongs to only that average 2 function, not nobody else. Only average 2 function can use this average because it is inside the body of that function. Nobody else, only average. So it is local. For example, I am local citizen of Turkish statement. And somebody else may be the local citizen of, for example, Libya. Okay? Local means that it belongs to somewhere and nobody else can see and touch it and can use it. Okay? So this is a local variable. Now, we got the number one and number two as a formal parameters. So actually formal parameters are also local variables. Do you understand this? Formal variables are also local variables. Do you understand? It is important. What about the actual parameters? Do you think that actual parameters are also local variables? No, no. Because remember that the actual parameters are used in the function call. In function call. And this is function definition. So Whatever the actual parameter values are, these are the values, are sent to the formal parameters. That's all. Okay? So it's important to understand this. Now, so somebody will give us the num1 value for us by using the actual parameters. When in the function call, they will provide the value for num2. Since we have the num1 and num2, now we have to create a local variable. Now the using num1 plus num2 over 2.0, now we have the average value of these two numbers, and we can return the average value. Since num1 and num2 integers, we have to divide with 2.0. I think everybody remembers this. All right. All right. So let's see the whole code. Remember, I will repeat again. In a conventional C code, we begin with the include statements. We continue with the function prototypes. Then we have the main function. Then we have the function definitions. So this is the convention in C. Okay, don't forget. Now, in the function call, you see that there is a function call. We are calling the function. We have to check for the three things, remember? First, if it returns something, is it correct or not? Yes, it will be returning float, and the name of that variable, a variable, is float, no problem. Is the name of the function correct or no? Yes, it's correct. How many parameters in the function prototype and the function call? 2. Do you think the first parameter data type is the same in local and actual parameters? In formal parameter, it's integer. In the actual parameter, it's integer. First one. The second one, the first formal parameter integer, the second formal parameter integer. The second actual parameter is integer. So no problem. So you can run it. When you call the function, okay, when you call a function, what happens? Remember. At that point, the compiler, when you see the function call, it will first check that if it knows it or not. Yes, it knows because there is the function prototype. Okay. If it is correct, then it will go to the function definition. It will do everything here, then returns that value to here. Okay. So now actually what we have here now, when we return here after the function call, now look at here, after the function call, assume that now we just return here with some result. Assume that result is 5.600000. So read the statement now. Average is 5.6000. Now I can continue. Do you understand how the function call works? Okay, so I will repeat. Now, we have the function prototype. We have the function call. We have to check this return data type, function name, parameter list. If everything is correct, then at the function call here, you have to stop. You cannot continue with these and this. You cannot. You have to come to the function definition. You have to run everything. When it returns some value, you get the value. For example, what is the value? 5.600000. You need to come back to the function call back. Okay. In the function call, assume that now you are deleting all these. Assume, just assume. Imagine. And you are just writing the number here. 5.600000. Now, after the function call, what happens? Now pay attention there. Now we can do the assignment now. Now assignments, averages, blah, blah, do it. Then do it this, do it, and finish. Do you understand the function call? It works. How it works. Yeah, it's very important. All right. Let's do it again together. Let's do it again. Now, we know we learned this function. We are at this function call right now as a compiler. So far, what we have learned? We have learned that value one is, I will put value one like that. Value one is 5. Value two is 8. And I am going to call the value one and value two. So when you call something, you have to stop this. You have to paste the value one to first parameter. So I will repeat again. First actual parameter value to the first formal parameter. The second actual parameter value to the second formal parameter. But what we are passing? We are only passing the value of them, not the variable itself. So this is called pass by value. This method is called pass by value. In compare 114 course, you are gonna see pass by reference. And in C++ to 5 course, you are gonna see pass by pointers and reference as well. Okay. But here we are gonna see only pass by value. So what we are passing? Only the value of the actual parameters. Now, after passing, you assume that it looks like assignment. Now, what is the num1 value? I will clear. What's gonna be the num1 value? Okay. Here, after the function call, now num1 will be 5. Num2 will be 8. So we created local variable. Now it is 5 + 8, which is 13 over 2.0. It makes what? 6.5, 1, 2, 1, 2, 3. Now that is the value assigned to the average. What is the value of average? Now, what is the value of average? It is 6.500. Now, I will return this average, but I will not return the average. I will return the value of average to exactly that point. To that point in the function call. And assume that, okay, assume that I just clear everything here, but I put only the return value. What is the return value? Remember? 6.5, 1, 2, 1, 2, 3. Now I can do the assignment. Huh? Now I can do the assignment and then continue this and this. Everybody understands how the function calls, how we pass the values. Huh? Everybody understands? Yes. All right. So in the parameter passing, actual parameters are the parameters that appear in the function call, as in the example. And formal parameters are the parameters that appear in the function header. Actual and formal parameters are matched by position, corresponding positions. Each formal parameter receives the value of its corresponding actual parameter, only the value. All right. So corresponding actual and formal parameters do not have to have the same name. They don't have the same name, but they can have. But remember that formal parameters are the local variables to the function. And actual parameters are the local parameters to the calling function. All right. So corresponding actual and formal parameters must be of the same data type with some exceptions. What is the exception? What's the exception? Implicit type casting. Implicit type casting. All right, let's continue. So local variables, functions only see, it means that have access to update, change, delete, print, only their own local variables. So some function cannot reach the other function's local variable. So it includes the main function as well. So main function cannot reach other function's local variables. And as I said, formal parameters are declarations of local variables. The values passed are assigned to those variables. So you can think that function call is an assignment process from actual parameters to the formal parameters. Other local variables can be declared within the function body. There is another type of variable called a global variable, but I don't want to teach at all because they are a major source of errors and I don't suggest anybody to use it, so I will not teach you. Okay. Now, I will talk about local variables with some important examples. Now, please stay with me and follow with me. Now, let's do our understanding how to write a C code. First, we have the include. Then we have the second order as a function prototype. Then we have the main function. And lastly, we have the function definition. Remember these four parts? We have always four parts in C in general. Include, function prototype, main, and function definitions. User defined function definitions. As a compiler, you begin first including the standard libraries. Then second, you learn about the user defined functions. Then third, you begin with the main function and you do everything in the main function. But if in the main function there is a function call, look, here is that part is the function call. Okay, that part is the function call. But look, this part is an assignment. Do you understand this? The red one is the function call, the blue one is the assignment, is just a statement. Okay. Let me continue. Now, you can do average variable declaration. These are the variable declaration with initialization. Any problem so far? Okay, no problem. Now, here is a assignment, but right side is a, remember in the assignment, right side is always an expression. Remember what we do with expressions? We need to evaluate the expression, then find the result, then assign the result to the left side variable. Do you remember? We try to memorize this. In assignment, right side is always an expression. We have to evaluate the expression. We have to find the result. Then we have to assign the result to the left side variable. We are gonna do the same thing. Right side is an expression. Look here. Right side is an expression. All right. So what we have to do? with evaluated. Evaluate means that function call. When you call the function, what is the value one value? It is 5. So you have to send these 5 to here. Now, what is the value of num1? It's gonna be 5. Now, value 2, what is the value 2? Value is 8. Now you have to send to 8 here because it's function call. Now, after assigning the actual parameters values to the formal parameter values, it is integer, both of them, and it is integer here, no problem. Now we can do, now look, there is average, a local variable. Now num1 plus num2 over blah blah, average. Now at that point, you have to return where you are called from. Where did you called from? In here. Here you are called from. Now what you are gonna do? Basically what you are gonna do is, as I showed you, assume that, imagine that. Okay, you are gonna write the result here. Okay, you are gonna write the result. For example, 6.500000. And then print the average. Then print the average, print this and return 0 and finish the program. Is that clear? Now look below here. In below, I will clear everything. We have a delimiting line here, separating line. These variables belongs to main function. And these variables belongs to this function. So in main function, you cannot write these things. Look at here. Forget here. You cannot write here. Forget here. Now, can I write average? Can I write or not? Look, this average is here. Or look at here, it is here. And inside the average, it is written 6.5000, right? Do you think that in main function, in printf, can I use this average variable? Yes or no question. Can I use this average inside the main function? Can I use, yes or no? Of course, no, because this average belongs to that function. It does not belong to main function because it is defined inside the body of average 2. You cannot use any other variable here. You cannot use it. Okay. In the exams, there will be lots of questions about like that. Now, look at here. It's interesting to see what happens here. Now, include function prototype, main, and function definition. First of all, you have to understand that. This average is a local variable, and here, this another local variable. Do you think that these two are the same variables? Do you think that these two average variables are the same? Yes or no question? Do you think they are the same? Yes or no? They are not the same. Look. One belongs to, I will put some color, this belongs to this function, and I will put another color, let me put, this belongs to that function body, do you see that? So do you remember the toast analogy, toast, sandwich? So you cannot get somebody else's cheese from his sandwich, Everybody has its own sandwich. So here, these are not the same. These are not the same. Totally different. The names are the same, but I will show you. Pay attention here. Pay attention here. This average lives here. This average, okay, lives here. Assume that you have a friend whose name is Murat. Murat lives in Istanbul, Maine. You have another friend whose name is Murat, but he lives in Izmir. Do you think that because their names are the same, they are the same guys? Are they the same guy? No, because one lives in Istanbul, the other lives in Istanbul, they are totally different. So this average lives inside the average two function. This average lives inside the main function. Totally different. Is that clear to everyone? Yes or no? To the chat screen. Yes or no? It's really important. Okay, so I will continue. If you have any questions, I can repeat, but if you don't. So let's solve this question. Now, let me put here the average. Num1, so this is num1 and 5. And num2, 8. Okay, now there is the function call with the num1 and num2. The value of num1 will go to the that num1. Now, do you think that num1 and that num1 is the same, are the same or not? These two num1 variables are the same or not? Yes, no question. They are not. Because one lives in the main function, the other lives in the average two function. Only the names are the same. As in the example, Murat. There are lots of Murats. But every of them lives in some other cities, let me say. All right. So what is the value of num1 here? 5. Now, what is the value gonna be here? 5. Because 5 goes like that. Now, num2 goes to the here. So it's gonna be 8. Num2 is 8. Now we have the new average, not this average. Look, when you put the things, so 5 plus 8 over 2.0, we are gonna find 6.000. Now, 6.5 will be here or here. Which one? Left or the right? In the main or in the average two function? In which? Of course, it will be here, not here. You cannot go there because you are just writing the average here in your local. Now inside the average, there will be 6.50000. Now, at the return statement, you are gonna return to the function call. Remember our examples always. Now, here, what I am going to write here when I return, I will just write 6.5000. Now, at that moment, now I can do the assignment. Now, 6.5 will be here. 6.500. Okay. Any questions? Do you have any questions? What I'm trying to say is that this is a local variable for that. Okay. This is a local variable for that. These both, okay, these two are not the same. They have separate spaces in main memory. Okay, that's all. Now I will show another example for you. Simple but very useful. I hope everybody can follow now. First, include. Second, function prototype. Third, main. And lastly, we have the function definition. I think everybody memorized this. Okay. What's the name of the function? The name of the function is add1. How many parameters? Only one. What's the name of the parameter? Num1. What's the data type? Integer. Does that function returns a value? No. All right. Now, where is the function called here? You see that there is no assignment because there is nothing to return. Okay. Now, let's solve this together. Now, this is the first step. This is the second step. And main is the third step. Everybody memorize this. Okay, now here we have created a variable declaration with initialization. So we have the num1 here in that space, Istanbul. Okay, here is Istanbul. Here is Izmir, for example. Okay, now here is main. So here is main, but here is add1. All right, now num1, 5. This is okay. Now at the second, we have the function call. What I have to do as a compiler, I have to stop, get the num1 value. Get the num1 value. What was the num1 value? 5. So I will get the 5 to the formal parameter. So what is the formal parameter? Num1. So num1 now have the value of 5. Then I will continue like that. Increment the num1 by 5, 1. Now it's gonna be 6. Okay. And then I have to put the screen. In edit one, there is no backslash. So num1 equals, what is num1? 6. But here, look at here. Here it is num1 is still 5. Which num1 I am going to use? This num1 or this num1 in the add1? Of course, it is formal parameter. Now, look at here. I have nothing to return. When I finish, I come that point. I have nothing to do but continue. Now, in that print, in main, num1 equals to what? Do you think num1 equals to 6 or 5? It's 5. Because we only change num1 in the Izmir, in add1, not in main. Okay. So this num1 is different with this num1. Everybody understand? So this num1 belongs to add1 because it's a formal parameter. But here this is the local variable of main, so it is another. So in your main memory, remember main memory, in your main memory there are rows, remember, for each variable, let's say. So there is one memory space here, one address here, another address here, another address. You put the, for example, 6 here but 5 here. Everybody understands? They are not the same. They are not at the same memory location. They are two different variables. Okay. So there is a very simple program for you. Let's do as we did all the time. This is include. This is function prototype. This is what? Main. And where is the function definition? Where is that function definition? Of course, in the next slide. Okay, but let's work on this. So we have the integer x and y and z. So first we call the function with x, y, z, and then we are gonna call the function again with different parameters. We call the function. So how many function calls here? How many function calls? Look first here, then here, and then here. So what do you learn in that example there? Why we use the functions? Because functions are very powerful. We are gonna write the code once, but we are gonna use the same code for multiple times with different parameters. So what x, y, z do? For example, getting the average for three numbers, for example. So by providing different variables, different actual parameter values, we can call the same function for many times. So that's why we use function. Everyone understands this? Okay, I will continue. I will clear. Now here, what you see that it takes three parameters, okay? It prints the parameters and returns the sum of the parameters. So if you provide the parameters A, B, C, for example, 5, 6, 7, it will return the total of them, 5 plus 6 plus. Or if you provide, for example, 3 plus 5, 1, 2 minus 3, whatever, it will return you the total of them, okay? So what you see that the result, let's go over the results step by step. All right, now it's very clear that if you provide the 3, 4, 5 in the function call, here is the function call, a print result, what's gonna be on the screen? On the screen we are gonna see A3, B4, C4, why? Because it's printed in the function body. Look in the function body. Star in the function body. But it's what it will return the summation of these three numbers later. So now the result is 13. Why? Because look at integer A, integer B, integer C, we are in the formal parameters, and in the actual parameters they are all integer, no problem. So it's good. But look at now. Now 6 plus 4, y plus 2, and 9 are the actual parameters. So what happens? Actually, we don't send this 6 plus 4, but we send 10 to the parameter A. We are not gonna send y plus 2 because we are gonna only sending the values. Y plus 2 makes 6. And C is 9, no problem. So the result is okay. Now, so far so good. But look at here, a strange example. Assume that if we call the function A with 2.1, 3.5, 4.0, what happens? Remember that function A, formal parameters are integer, integer, integer. What happens? So you remember that actually in the implicit typecasting, the float numbers will be truncated to integers here, and the A will be 2, B will be 3, and C will be 4. It is truncated, it's not rounded up, truncated. So what is integer number? Remember, a number with a without a decimal point. Okay, so the result 9. So don't forget. But this make you, this provides you very different results that you expect it to be. So don't use this kind of function calls. So always respect to the function formal parameter types. Okay, always respect to that. Now you are sending float numbers to the integer formal parameters. Don't do it. Okay, because integer A, integer, integer. So don't do this. Because sometimes your result will be very different than what you would like to see. Okay, don't do this. Okay, so don't use implied conversions. All right. So we have the another examples with the predefined functions. You see that predefined function. Okay. So I have to summarize about the functions. Functions should do one thing and do it well. So if your function statements are more than a couple of statements, 5, 6, 7, Believe me that mostly you are not doing or you are not using functions correctly. A function should do one thing, a simple thing at a time. So functions can only return one thing and not two or three things, but in compare 2 to 6, you will learn that it can be data structures as well as a simple variable. It is better to have more than one function than one complicated function. So if you write down one function and it seems to be very complicated, more than 5, 6 statements, then you have to again decompose that function into different functions. Okay, I will show a very good example of this decomposition next week. Now, never write the same code twice. So if you are writing the same code in different places in your C program, so you have to understand that you have to write one function, then you have to call this function in these various places. Limit your function to a maximum 50-100 lines of code and commands. Believe me, it is too long. Do not do it. 50 and 100 lines are too much. Many functions have only one line of code. That's the reality. So if you use Linux, for example, it is an open system. You can check the Linux code and you would see that 5, 6 lines of codes in that operating system for each function. So believe me that in professional codes, there will be very, very few lines in each function, but you will see hundreds of functions are calling each other. Forgetting to return a value from a function that is supposed to return a value can lead to unexpected errors. Programs should be written as a collection of small functions. The function prototype, function header, and function calls should all agree in the number type, and order of arguments and parameters and the type of the return value. Otherwise, the compiler will generate error messages. So, do you have any questions?